ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا ومرشدنا وحجتنا وشفيعنا محمد، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمدٍ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وطاعته، وأحثكم على التمسك بهدي قرآنه وسنة نبيه، فقد قال الله جل من قائل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. My dear children, dear brothers, sisters, gold mining companies, before they are successful in bringing gold to the surface, they have to do lots of preparations. They have to do research. They have to find approximate places where gold has potential to be found according to their research, the right time to mine for gold. They don't just basically go somewhere and they start digging. If they find gold, fine. If they don't find it, they will try another place. That would be a big waste of time, energy. They don't do it that way. We know that. And I'm mentioning this because for 18 days now, since the month of Rabi al-Awwal started, the seasonal digging for gold is basically digging in the wrong place. And every year, it seems, we go somewhere, we dig, we don't find anything, we just get tired and we wait until the next year and we go somewhere else and we start digging. And we use the same machinery, the same tactic that did not work, that did not produce gold. And by that I mean every year. And for 18 days now, well, now it started to basically people to gather their machines, their instruments, and hide them until next year and be prepared. Next year, the same digging will take place in the wrong place. You guessed what I'm talking about. In Ramadan, we have the same attempt to dig somewhere. When will Ramadan start? When will Arafat be? When is Eid al-Fitr be? When is we always dig in the, what difference does it make? And we've been actually digging to find out, is celebrating the Prophet's birthday on the 12th of Rabi al-Awwal acceptable? No, it's not acceptable. I'll show you the proof. No, I have another proof. And we keep digging in the same place. What did that do? Whether it is the 12th of Rabi al-Awwal, or the 17th of Rabi al-Awwal, or the 9th of Rabi al-Awwal, whether it is in Ramadan, what does that do to the massacre in Gaza? What did that do to eliminate the corruption in Lebanon and in Iraq and in Algeria and in Libya and in Kashmir? What difference did it make to silence bigots? Bigots that came out on television to say, you people are not the real Canadians because you don't have the party displayed as a symbol of Canada. What did we do to get those people change their mind about who we are? You know why this is continuing? And you know the sad thing, it will continue because we are digging in the wrong place. We think that this is where we will get gold. Our Islam for now 14 and 41, 1441 years has been buried under layers of dust, because this is what happens to things that are not used properly. And they are getting deeper and deeper under the layers of sand. And you know, sometimes when we suspect that we may find something, we use the wrong instruments. And in the process of digging, we damage what we want to get And sometimes we start digging in the wrong place and we don't find the real Islam. Celebrate or no celebrate, use the word or don't use the word. But what is most important is to really rediscover our Islam, the Islam of Muhammad ibn Abdullah. You know something? The confusion that we got is from two words, the word celebrate and the word birth, which we connect with birthday. And we start to think birthday is, this is how people celebrate birthdays, so this is not part of the sunnah. But the reality is, we need to know more about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, I'm glad today, we have a large number of our children, our sons and daughters. And I want the parents, not now because the khutbah is on, but when you leave the masjid and you are in your cars, turn to your children and ask them, or tell them, I should say, because this is what we end up doing. Tell them, I want you to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tell them that. You know something, out of respect, out of love for you, because you are telling them to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they'll tell you, okay. But down deep inside, they are saying, how could I genuinely love someone I don't know much about? How many of our children know enough about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Let me go to how many among us know enough about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are expected to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala genuinely, spontaneously. Because when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to worship Allah because of love. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Everything is about love. But if you expect your children to love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have to know enough about Allah and about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the reality is, they don't. You know, we teach them, the first thing we teach our children is how to recite the Fatiha. And we get so excited when they start to say the Fatiha, whatever way they say it, and they say Allahu Akbar, they say the Fatiha. And in the Fatiha that we recite in our salat, we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. We are turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, Allah, guide us on the straight path. But you know, before you are guided, you need a guide. Who is guiding us on the straight path? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Ash-Shura, addressing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. So who is our guide? It is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How would you follow a guide that you don't know? It just does not happen. Do you usually tell your children when they are young, don't follow strangers? If a stranger asks you to go with them, don't go. Out of safety. And how, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that the best guide, when you say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, Ya Allah, guide us on the straight path, that the best guide, not the only guide, is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. You are the one who guides to the straight path. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَدْ أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكُمْ ذِكْرًا رَسُولًا
يتلو عليكم آيات الله مبينات ليخرج الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات من الظلمات إلى النور. In سورة الطلاق Allah سبحانه وتعالى is telling us, be righteous, O people of faith, because Allah sent down to you a messenger who recites mindful passages so that you can follow them, so that you can go from darkness to light. And you know, we are now experiencing darkness. When Muslims, let me make it a little bit narrower. When Muslim leader, no, let me make it a little bit more narrow. When leaders of Muslims, this is better. It's better than say Muslim leaders, because you know what I mean. When leaders of Muslims are seeing images, now we have social media and it's easy to see, but it's not easy to tolerate. See, this morning I saw a toddler injured, covered with blood, sitting on an operating table, looking at a nurse as if to say, can you help me? Why did this happen to me? And it's, by the way, not only happening in Gaza, even though in 2 days, now 3 days in Gaza, a large number fell as martyrs. When we know that this is happening and Muslims or leaders of Muslims continue to make attempts to follow in the footsteps of more advanced countries and invite people to enjoy carnivals and to enjoy entertainment venues and to do all kinds of things that are alienating Muslims themselves. When this is happening, this is darkness. But Islam came to deliver us out of darkness into light. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah At-Talaq, what I just recited to you, that when you follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will be delivered from darkness to light. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us in Surah Al-Anfal, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Look at this. Now, the context came about the people of Mecca, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we know that, you know, scholars of Quran teach us that the passages of Quran are to be understood according to their general meaning. And here it says that Allah is not going to impose punishment on people while you are with them. Now, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam physically is not with us, but he is supposed to be with us by his teachings, by his principles, by his sunnah. He is with us when we live his lifestyle. But because we are away from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is not with us. Because if he is with us, then things would be different. I assure you, not I assure you, the Quran assures us. If he is with us, things would be totally different. But you say, are you saying that it's the fault of the people of Gaza? No. If you remember the last khutbah I gave a couple of months ago, I said there are three categories of people that are caught in areas of conflict. And the ones that are falling now, the toddler and the mothers and the fathers and those innocent people, these are continuing the passage of life as shaheed. So they are graduating with the biggest honor.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them to be shaheed, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is imposing punishment on those who are not paying heed, on those who don't really want to know anything about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Please remember, my dear children, you know, you are taught that to be a Muslim, you have to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. And I say to all of us that when we live the Shahada, please remember that the Shahada is like a bird with two wings. Have you ever seen a bird flying with one wing? Have you ever considered that it would suffice to say La ilaha illallah to be a Muslim? Our shahada, our testimony of faith is made of the shahada of La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. We have to fly with two wings, and La ilaha illallah, which is the principle of Tawheed, is the foundation. But then we have to understand how to be a Muslim. We have to follow our guide. We have to move behind the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But if we try to run in front of him and go and find our way, we are not going to get to our destination, which is Jannah. You want to go in front of him, because sometimes, you know, at camp, you know, kids like to get so hyper sometimes, and they just go in front of their counselor. And the you know, even in Hajj, I remember, you know, when we want to go somewhere, the Hujjaj are so anxious to get to Mina, to get to Muzdalifa, to get to, they just go in front of their guide, and then the guide say, please stay behind, not because I want to just enjoy being in the front, but you really need to be with everyone else to follow. And our guide here is the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is why we really need to encourage a form of celebration of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whether now or 3 months from now or 10 months from now, it doesn't matter. You know what? If you want to celebrate the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and call it, if you want to celebrate the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yes, I say the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can do it in the Hijjah, do it in Shawwal, do it any month you want. But you would say, did you say celebrate them? Yes, because in order for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hand over the sunnah to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had to create him, he had to bring him to this life. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, why do we have to fast Monday? It is a sahih hadith that he answered by saying, because it is a day wherein I was born. He mentioned wherein it's a day I was born. And he wasn't just basically boasting about who he is, but he was telling us that for every thing, there is a beginning. And we know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not start to establish his sunnah when he became 40 years of age. Right from the beginning, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam lived an exemplary life. He did not say, I'm still a teenager and I can do anything I want now. Some of the young people, you talk to them, why are you doing this? Why are you behaving in this way? They say, yeah, don't talk to him, I'm still too young. Or some parents say, leave him alone, he's still too young. He will readjust afterwards. And when it is time to readjust, that son or daughter is so transfixed on their ways that it becomes impossible to change. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, for us, it's okay to celebrate his life, his birth, the right way. Let us dig for gold where gold is, not just anywhere. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. May دعاء الله سبحانه وتعالى
He will accept our dua. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My dear family, it is really sad to see that, you know, we are looking in the opposite direction when things are on the other side. Whether these are the good things, whether these are the challenges, whether these are, you know, the dangers, but to just be oblivious and look away from where things are is sad. We have to just get our children around us and tell them where that guide is. And when our children see us following the right guide, they follow suit. When our children see us from early age putting our head for sujood on the ground, they will start by playing a game with us. They will come look us in the eye. They don't understand what's going on, but soon they will know that this is Salat. When our children will ask us, you say Sunnah, Sunnah, Sunnah. Tell us what is Sunnah. You know, most of us now, if asked to make a list of certain aspects of the Sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, unfortunately, we end up telling them, okay, right, son, right, I'll tell you, you know, what the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to use the miswak before salat. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to eat with your right hand. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to fold the pants like this before you pray. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to, you know, make short your mustache. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to grow a beard. The sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is to put a cap. The sunnah of Rasulullah, this is what we tell them. How many among us, when asked about the sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we tell them right down, the sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is that he was respectful to his elders. He had mercy on those who are young. He made sure that the environment around him is clean. He made sure that he was prompt for his appointments. He respected time. He loved the family. He took care of the poor. He did this. This is what we have to tell them as the sunnah of Rasulullah. But unfortunately, we made the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam so irrelevant to the thinking of our children nowadays, to the point that they cannot relate to it. When you tell the children, how many children have a miswak? How many children are told that it is haram to use a toothbrush or to use toothpaste? How many among our children were misguided? Please, let us redirect the path and move properly before we will even start to dig in for gold, but we may not be able to reach it because it would be way too deep. God forbid. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وخطايانا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا وكن معنا ولا تكن علينا عباد الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Here at the center, we put our heels on the line, not our toes. So please make sure your line is straight by having your heels on the line.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. محمد رسول الله. والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود. ذلك مثلهم في التوراة. ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرج شطأه فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع